Okay, so today we're going to learn a very nice trick, which is creating pop-up for lead generation using Thrive Leads. So Thrive Leads is basically a very nice plugin for creating this pop-up for lead generation. And although it's a, I mean, it's not a free plugin; it's a, paid plugin. But yes, we have purchased it for a client of ours, and now. Today we're going to create a slide-in pop-up. You can create a number of pop-ups using this particular plugin. I mean, it can be the appearance of pop-up can differ from there are a lot of options available, but what we can do is, like, here we just need to create the slide-in pop-up, and for that I'll share the tutorial today. So let's start with it. So for this we need three things. First of all we need Thrive Themes member dashboard access, because you need to purchase that Thrive Leads plugin. Okay, so and in this tutorial you will also going to learn that how you can use Thrive Leads plugin for creating the for lead generation. Okay, second thing we need, obviously we need access to the website, that is the WordPress website or the WordPress dashboard. And third thing we need is the MailChimp account, or you can use any other email service provider like GetResponse, Aweber, any email service provider, but we are using MailChimp here. So all things are ready. So client has already purchased the Thrive Leads plugin, and we have installed this product manager plugin into the WordPress, and the dashboard, like when we go to Thrive Themes product manager, like this is the Thrive dashboard, and here we can access this Thrive Leads dashboard. So this is the Thrive Leads dashboard that we'll be working on for creating the pop-up. So this is how the Thrive Leads dashboard looks like. Okay, so this is your basic dashboard, and we'll try create a pop-up from here. So first of all, you can understand the basic layout here. You can see here that the basic layout is having the lead groups, then lead shortcodes, then Thrive boxes, and then sign up seek, one click sign up links. Today we will start with creating a lead group, because always whenever you will create any pop-ups you need to categorize them. So we'll create a lead group here, and we can name this lead group as, what should we name it, okay, so we'll name this as ebook lead magnet. Ebook lead magnet, because we will be using the ebook as a lead magnet. So we are creating this lead group, and let me show you the ebook. So if we go into the media, then this is the actual ebook that we'll be giving away in return for an email from the interested person. Okay, so this is the ebook in PDF format. Okay, so now what we'll do is, now it will do is, we have created this. Now we need to add a new type of opt-in form here. So now you can see here that different options are there, right? We can add the pop-up in different forms. It can be a light box, or it can be within the content, or it can be post footer, or it can be added as a ribbon, scrolling, like different things can be done. But we'll add a slide-in pop-up here. Okay, and okay, so this is done. Now we need to add a form. Okay, instead of slide in, I think we can try other design, because I think for this type of ebook, a normal pop-up would be better. So I'll delete this form type, I'm sorry, but I think a normal pop-up, yeah, Lightbooks pop-up would be much better. So we'll go with this one and we'll try to create this Lightbooks pop-up. See, the basic process will remain same. So the only difference is the type of design. So now we can add a form here, okay, and we can create a form now. Ebook, financial planning in COVID-19. Okay, so let's try creating this form. Now display immediately on page load. Okay, page load, sorry. No, we don't want it. We want it to be appearing after a certain period of time, around 5 seconds or 4 seconds. 4 seconds would be good. Smart exit, yes, we want it. Save it. The process is same. Like I told you, the process will remain the same, and we can go, we can show it all the time. All the time we want to show it. It should change. Okay, animation, it's zoom in, and now we can edit the design. Okay, let's try editing the design. I'm really excited. See, by the time it's loading up, I just let you know that like client had already, you know, a cover for the ebook. I mean, this was the cover of the ebook. So, you know, you can always create a 3D ebook cover. You can simply write create 3D ebook cover in Google, and there are certain websites that let you create 3D ebook cover. I use this DIY book design and it created a 3D ebook cover for me. I'll show you. Let me show you like right now. It would be good. So it's taking some time. Okay, so this is the 3D ebook cover it has created for me. See how nice it looks like. I mean, people, you know, it really attracts the attention. So we can close it, and now where we were creating the form. Okay, it's taking some time. Okay, so now I'm resuming, and now these are the different templates that are appearing. So what we can do is we can try creating a nice clean pop-up for this particular website. Okay, which one is good? Now again, it's taking a little bit time. Just send me the wall. This is also good, I think. The website analytics are useless. Financial. I think this is also good. This is kind of a 3D pop-up. Yeah, this is a 3D pop-up. This is also good. This is also good. Which one we should go with? No. We need to keep it very simple. This design, I mean, choosing design is really hectic. Tuk. See, we need to make it little good. That's why, you know, I'm taking some time. Okay, I'll try this one. This is having some 3D look, and I want to try it because it's giving some 3D look. So let me try. So now this is the basic design that we need to edit. So let's first change the image, so we can replace the image and we can, you know, upload the design that we have created. So this is the design that we have created. So let's try. Okay, so we have added it. Now you can, you know, drag it little bit. Oh wow, it's giving a nice 3D look that I expected. So we can, you know, drag it a little bit and make it, okay, this is a max, we can do it. So now we can title it. What is the title of the this particular ebook? A guide to financial planning. A Guide to Financial Planning in the Era of COVID-19. A Guide to Financial Planning in the Era. Era should be small, I think. Era of I think we should have, you know, we can make it black. Let me see, we can make it black, apply it, and let's we can unbold it. Okay, a guide to financial planning in the era of COVID-19. How does it look like, man? So this is the main, I think, a guide to financial planning in the era of COVID-19. In the era of COVID-19, I think we are good to go. Yeah, the title is correct. So now we can, you know, also put, if you want, we can also put we can, you know, drag it, you know, you can use this layout and positioning tool and you can move it little upward to make that 3D look. So a guide to financial planning in the era of COVID-19. Okay, and we can give a title like a subheading also. So let's see if any subheading is available. 2020 year of chaos. But I don't think this is looking good. So what we can do is, what's inside that particular book? Actually, I'm not sure. Why don't we open it up? Let's try to see what's inside the book so that we can create a subheading. See, you need to do this much of work before, you know, finalizing the design. I think this line moves, I think this line looks good to me. This one, identify, where was it? Identify best actions and moves to make. Identify the best actions and moves to make. This looks good. Identify the best actions and what is that? Moves to make. Best actions and moves to make. Okay, best actions and moves to make in times of crisis. Perfect, it's looking good, man. Okay, we can delete it. Save it before it. Okay, it's saved. Yes, I want this free ebook. Yes, I want this free download. So now, you know, you need to ensure that like this particular theme matches the overall website. So let's see the overall website, what color they are following. And they are following a multiple colors, which is not good. But what we can do is, they're having a kind of a purple shade, so we can try a light purple shade here for this blue background. Let me try a blue background. If I can find how can I find it Okay, here you can make the changes. Okay, perfect. And this line also, I think it needs to be changed in that particular color. How does it look like? Yeah, it's good. So now, and this one also we can change to purple. I think that is more appropriate as the theme is following that particular tone. Oh, so you can see, I mean, this particular plugin, it makes things so easy for you for making all these changes. Okay, so the pop-up is ready now. We can save it. Okay, now the next thing that we need to do is we need to link our MailChimp account and create a functionality so that people who are, you know, clicking on this button, they get this ebook into their emails. So how we can do that is we can select this button, and now we can select to I think there was an option here somewhere for editing this pop-up. Oh, I'm not getting it. Where was that? Okay, here, you know, default, this is the default state, and this is the state one. This is the state one. Like, let's see what's the state one. No, we don't want it. What's the state one? No, we don't want state one. Like this. We don't want this. We can delete it. What state they have created? Okay, we can delete it from here. Perfect. So now we need to have a functionality for this button, and we can add a, how can we add? Okay, we can add a target link here. So how can we add a target link here? In order to add a target link here, let's see, I think we'll have to add a contact form here. Maybe we can try this thing. Let's try adding a lead generation form instead. Okay, we can add a lead gen form here. Yeah, so lead generation form needs to be added here because we want people to directly enter their email and get this. Okay, so what particular buttons we are having here? Let's see. So I think this is good. Do we need both name and email? No, I don't think this is enough. I think, or no, we need name and email. I mean, we need to, you know, contact them afterwards. So what we can do is we can opt-in form. Let's try opt-in form here. Okay, so instead of adding another lead form here, what we have done is, like, because this design was looking really good to me. So what we have done is, like, inside leads, this Thrive leads, it gives you functionality to add a state here. So first what we did, we, you know, added a state here. So this is the other state, and this is named as state one. Okay, in this, what we did, we simply added the form, the lead generation form. We dragged it here, selected the design, changed the colors and everything. Okay, and this is how we created a state one. So now this is the default state. Okay, now if any person will click on that particular button, then we can tell that, like, you can switch to the state one. So this is the button. Now if we go to this animation and action section here, you can select, like, you know, on clicking it should switch to state one. we have added, like you can add it, you can, you know, do this particular thing here. Okay, so now let me show you like how it will work. We'll go to the preview section here. Okay, so this is the pop-up. Now if any person will click here, they'll get this format. Okay, so this is how you can, you know, make it easy, and it looks good also. Okay, now the next thing is we need to add, you know, link MailChimp, so that whatever email come up here, it should go to the MailChimp account. Okay, and one more thing, I think we can, you know, there is a lot of space around this particular form, so we can change the layout a little bit. There's a lot of space, so we can reduce the space. Let's try make it 0 and 0. Okay, so now, and we can make the background as little gray. I think that would be, that would look good rather than, perfect. Okay, so we have added these particular sections. Now what we need to do is we need to name is required. Okay, and again email is also required. Okay, now we can link it, edit, add connection. Now here we can add the connection, we can add to the API dashboard. So once, you know, we need to connect MailChimp to the website first. Okay, so let's go to MailChimp, and here I think we have got integration. Under integration we can integration. Okay, and let's go to website here. Website backend. Here it is. So now we need to link MailChimp in it. So how can we do it? Let me check. Okay, so MailChimp gives you this functionality of integration, so we can integrate it with WordPress. Okay, so now what we need to do is we can, okay, we have already entered. Now we can select the audience. Okay, audience is already get code. So now what is this? Guest custom website code. Copy the code and paste it into your website's HTML. By pasting our code into your site, you agree. Connect WordPress to MailChimp to enable pop-up forms and Google remarketing ads. Okay, so I can copy this. But before, you know, how to add this type of code. Now this is again, I'll, you know, share a trick with you. There's a very nice plugin which helps you in, you know, pasting up all these codes. I hope I remember the name of that plugin. I know. Let me try. I think it is HFIC. Or HFCI, I'm not sure. Okay, it's HFCM, Hero Footer Code Manager. So we'll install it. Now this is the HFCM plugin that is installed here. Okay, so now what we'll do is we'll add a new snippet here, okay, and copy the code from here. MailChimp integration code. We need to paste this code here. It should be within the header, and let's save it. So now we have pasted this code in the header section. So now if we go to HFCM, where was it? All snippets. Okay, so now we can try to check connection to see if it's working. No, still not working. Okay, I think the site URL was wrong little bit. It was HTTP, but now it's HTTPS. So we'll try it again. Copy this and edit this snippet here, and let's try to change the snippet, update it. Okay, so for connecting now MailChimp, although we have, you know, entered that code, but you know, one more thing we can do here is, like, we can go to the Thrive dashboard here, and here I think in the API connections we can add MailChimp, like we can integrate it with Thrive Leads. So add a connection, and yeah, I think it will work here. MailChimp and API key. Now it needs the API key. So where can you get that API key? Let me see. Let me go to the integration. No. Where is the API key? View more integration. Okay, so API key is located. Like, for that you need to go into the website, and then you can go to the extra, and then you can go to the API section here. I'll be hiding the API key from you, because I mean, we cannot. Okay, so we have got the API key. Now we can connect it. Let's see. Okay, its connection is ready. Perfect. So MailChimp is now, you know, we can test it also. See how easy they have made, like Thrive themes, they have made it so easy for you. Okay, so now I think we will be able to, you know, connect that particular form. Oh yeah, we can connect it now. Add a connection. See, MailChimp is appearing here. Perfect. So now we can, you know, choose a mailing list. That is okay. Grouping, single opt-in. Okay, apply. Perfect. So now this form is linked to the MailChimp. Now whoever person will register here, they will be getting a MailChimp. Their details will get saved into MailChimp account of ours. Okay, now send leads to. Now we can, you know, select here also. We can also send the leads to email. I'll not go into details here. Okay, now after successful submission, what should be happen? Now after successful submission, the person should be getting that particular ebook. So what we can do is, we can, you know, share the ebook. Where was it? Media library. This was the ebook, and this is the link of the ebook. So now if a person has submitted the details, they will get this ebook.
perfect. I think it should work as we are expecting. Okay, so should we check it now? Let's check it. Ah, not this one. I think we need to switch to state default state first. Okay, now let's preview this particular form inside Thrive Leads dashboard only. Okay, suppose this is I think a little closer. Why is it happening here? Like, it should not be closer. There should be some gap here. Why that gap is not coming? Layout position. Okay, I think that should work. Let me reload it. Yeah, a little bit gap is there. Now when I click this, suppose I write Vijay, and suppose I'm writing this email sign up, awesome. So, and let's check like that particular email is coming up here or not. So let's go to the audience. Okay, so let's check the two contexts. So you can see here the email is here. So email is saved here, name is saved here, and I think I should be getting some mail also. No, mail is not there. So let me delete this. Okay, let it remain there. Let me try. Okay, let me unsubscribe it for now. Okay, now let me check it on the actual website, like how it will look like on the actual website. Let's have a look. It's not working. Okay, it's not working because we haven't changed the settings here. Now we want to display it on the desktop as well as on the mobile. And now what we can do is, I think now it should work perfectly. So let me try to reload the website again. Let's reload the website from the other browser. Okay, I hope it will work now. No, it's not working. Why it's not working? Okay, it's not working because there is a targeting option here that we need to select. So targeting we haven't selected. So we need to show this particular on all the pages. Yeah, on all the pages we can show it. Save and close. Okay, I don't think there is any error now, and it should work now. Come on. We are waiting for you, pop up. Come on. Why are you not coming? 4 seconds. I think we gave 4 second time. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 seconds have crossed. Why is it not coming? Okay. So I finally found the fault that we were having. So the fault was that, like, when we go to the display setting,
Thrive Leads consider the pages both and the front page as different. Like for example, if you select all pages, then it will not contain all the posts and the front page. So when I selected front page, all pages and all posts, then my pop-up is working. So let me show you like how it is working now. So if somebody loads up here, awesome. See, so this is how the pop-up is working. And now if any person clicks here, they'll put up their main name and email, suppose test@gmail.com, get free ebook. Oh, it should work. Please don't tell me it's not working. Okay, it's working. Yeah, so you see, here's the PDF. Okay, so people will get this PDF when they leave their email IDs. Okay, so let's check again the context, if we have bought the new contact here. Let's refresh it. Ta-ta-da. Okay, so we are having this email here and the name is also here. So this is how you can create a lead magnet on WordPress website using Thrive Leads. Okay, so I hope this tutorial is clear to you now, and you can do a lot more things for collecting the leads. This is only a sample that I have shown you. You can do a lot more things. So if you are looking out for a discount, you can click on the link in the description. Okay, so you can expect a discount using my link for purchasing this particular lead generation plugin. And if you are looking to get more information also, then I'll also share a link in the description, like how you can use this plugin for different things for related to lead generation. So I hope this video is clear to you now, and thanks for being with me for last 40 minutes. I know it's a little long.